All right, it's time for one of my favorite segments we do here sometimes on American Airgunner called This Old Airgun with the Godfather of Airguns, of course. You know why I like this so much?
Why?
It's because I never know what we're doing. This is pretty much your segment, and I'm just here to introduce it.
Isn't that fun?
I love it. So what on earth am I looking at today?
I got something cool for you, Rossi.
I can't imagine.
Back in 1888, the Plymouth Iron Windmill Company was having trouble. They couldn't sell their iron windmills. They were very expensive. Farmers wanted wooden windmills, and farmers didn't have much money anyhow.
Sure.
They were on the brink of going out of business until they discovered a BB gun that was built by a local guy by the name of Clarence Hamilton. And the president of the Plymouth Iron Windmill Company, when he saw this thing, he said, "Clarence, that's a daisy," which was the vernacular of the time.
Yeah.
But it gave the gun its name. And that's the
Daisy.
Founding. Yeah. So what I have for you today is a replica, but it's more than a replica because it's made by Daisy.
Okay.
I actually have a new version of the Daisy, the original wire stock BB gun that they made in 1888.
And this is where Daisy, that we all know, came from.
Yes, that's right. That's right. This gun was made in about 2007.
Okay.
And there were 1,000 of them made, and it was sold to members of the Daisy Museum, which I am.
Uh-huh.
And then the ones that were left over were sold to the public in general for $300. If you had a real Daisy like this, it would be $2,500 to $3,500. That's just for an ugly one.
Right.
But if it were the first model, like this one is, it would be $10,000.
I can actually contribute to this story. I have been to the NRA National Museum, Rifle Museum,
right,
and got a chance to hold with white gloves the original Daisy BB gun that looked just like this, but obviously a lot older and less put together.
And worth a lot more money.
And worth a lot more money. And I asked if they could shoot it, and they said no. But I asked.
I'm going to change that today.
Really?
I'm going to let you shoot it, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, but before we do, let me show you a few more things here. Daisy actually went out of their way to make this as much like the original as they could.
Okay.
A couple of things are not correct. Some of the dimensions are a little more robust because the original broke very easily.
Ah.
And Daisy put a magnet in the barrel of this one to hold the steel BB. Back in 1888, they were shooting larger lead BBs, and the barrel was tapered on the inside. So they drop it in, it would just stop.
Okay.
So there's a little bit of difference. But they went to the process of winding the piston with candle wicking, which is exactly how the original was made. So this thing is that original.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Candle wicking.
Candle wicking. I'm talking about just the string that comes out of a candle.
So that's how you cock it.
No. That's what's around the piston to be the seal.
To be the seal.
That's the thing you oil when you oil the gun.
Got it. Huh.
Isn't that something?
Yes, it is something.
As Gallagher would say, and don't you want to know how it works?
I don't know who Gallagher is, but yes, I do.
Okay. He's the guy that smashes watermelons.
Got it. Okay.
Let's put our safety glasses on, and we'll go through this. And I got something else to show you while we're at it.
Yeah, all right.
These are Umarex BBs, which are very accurate in all BB guns. The problem with BBs, folks, is they go everywhere. So...
don't I know.
I have this flashlight whose other side, backside, is a very powerful magnet. And look what happens. There's all your BBs. Well, except for that one. Right there.
I mean, this is why you are the godfather of air guns.
Yeah.
This and this.
Pull them off one at a time, you know? It's real easy.
All right.
Okay. Now.
So I've got my BB, and I've got
BB.
My awesome 1888 gun.
Let's load the gun first.
Okay.
So tip it up.
Yep.
Drop a BB down the muzzle and listen for a little tiny click.
Okay. Heard it?
Okay.
A little magnet in there. Okay.
Take your rear sight and just pull back until it clicks. That's it. It's cocked. Push her forward. Now, I got to tell you.
Okay.
The trigger pull is like 18 pounds.
Okay.
No kidding. You're going to think you're going to break the gun, but we've got a target just aimed center of mass.
I love that we have targets in the cabin.
Isn't that neat?
Ha ha!
You want to do it again?
I do.
Okay.
I do.
You know how it works now.
Little click, all right.
This is what little boys did in 1888.
Man, this is... I feel like I'm shooting the original. Goodness gracious, you're not lying with this trigger.
Yeah, it's hard.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, that is... Thank you for this. This, because when you first opened, I was like, I've seen this gun before, thinking we were repeating something. But I forgot that it was like the original that I saw. Yeah. Because, right, when do I get to contribute to this old air gun?
Yeah. Well, you did now.
Man, I feel like you should have given me white gloves, too, so I didn't get so many fingerprints on it. But
it's
this
okay.
Is,
I'll wipe it down. It's brand new.
This is awesome. Thank you so much. So can people out there, can they buy this?
Not anymore. You can buy them used, but you can't buy new ones anymore. They're all sold out.
Okay.
I paid $300. They're beginning to ratchet up to around $500 now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, sir.
So if you can find one.
Always a pleasure.
You bet.
Tom Gaylord, the godfather of air guns right there with this old air gun. Stay with us. More American Air Gunner coming up after this.
Great.